Hello guys and welcome back for a brand new review. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can also give me a follow on Instagram to see exactly what I'm gonna review in the next few days. In today's video guys, we're gonna have a look at this pair of Air Force One, which apparently got the treatment which everyone was expecting for a while now, and I'm referring to the React midsole. So let's go ahead and also take them out of the box guys, which as you can see will come in this very simple gray box, which will just have Nike Air Force One written here at the top. So let's go ahead and take them out. So in today's video guys, we're gonna have a look at this new version for the Nike Air Force One React. So this very well known model guys from Nike, which is called the Air Force One, was actually released originally back in 1992 as a basketball shoe, but since then it transitioned to this lifestyle shoe, which every few years it's getting some minor improvements. This specific model guys was released here in the UK at the start of May for a retail price of £115. And this one will come with some major changes. So let's go ahead and do a breakdown of this one and see exactly what changed comparing with the normal one. So as you can see, starting here at the front of the shoe guys, we're gonna have your normal white leather, but this one will come in slightly different paneling. Usually, as you might know, the top part of the Tobo section will be stitched underneath this front part of the Tobo section, but this one will be stitched on top of it. So this is a very major change coming from Nike. Of course, we still gonna have your normal perforation hole for some breathability, but as you go to the actual lacing system guys, you can see that we're gonna have your normal punch out holes, but for this specific model we're also gonna have some metallic punch out holes in this orange color. As in for the actual laces, we're gonna have your normal flat white laces, and just underneath these laces guys, we're gonna have this very well padded tongue, which this time will be in this gray color, and we'll use a different material comparing with the normal one, which you get in the normal Air Forces One. As you can see, the design for the tongue, it's actually quite interesting, and we're also gonna have this Nike swoosh embossed here at the top of the tongue. But as you go towards the midfoot guys, you can see that we're gonna have a very nice small Nike swoosh here on the side, which is stitched in this black color. But as we get to the actual midfoot guys, you can see that transitioning from this white leather material, it will change to this transparent mesh material, which is also slightly a bit stretchy, but don't expect too much. So most definitely through this one your socks will be revealed. And from the midfoot going to the actual back of the shoe guys, you can see that we're gonna have this ripstop material in this white color again, which on top of it will have at least for the lateral side this Nike swoosh in this white color, and we're also gonna have a second one underneath in this black color. But as you can see on the medial side guys, I think they decided to just not finish this Nike swoosh, and just at the top of the heel section guys, you can see that we're also gonna have a stitched Nike Air and a swoosh in this black color, and just above it we're also gonna have a very small pull tab in this black color with some white rubberized dots. But as you go inside guys, you can see that we're gonna have a major change. So we're gonna have some padding here at the back, but as we go to the front, you can see that this one will actually go very low, but to be honest, I didn't find that to be a problem. This padding is actually quite good, and it will keep your whole ankle and heel section quite good in place. And also at the bottom, I also gonna have this blue foam insole, which will also have this Nike Air and the swoosh imprinted here at the heel section. But now as we go to the actual midsole, guys, you can see that at the front we're gonna have your normal rubberized material, which going to the back of the shoe, it will change to this see-through rubberized material, which will reveal that underneath we're gonna have this Nike React foam in this blue color. So you can see that on the medial side, this Nike React foam, it's actually quite visible. So this one really has this unfinished design, which to be honest, I kind of like it. And also this whole midsole, guys, will also be stitched as per the normal Air Forces 1. And now, guys, we can finish with this rubber outsole. So this one will also have this cutout holes, which will reveal this React foam underneath in this blue color. So this one, in my opinion, it's actually much better than the normal Air Forces 1, which they are slightly a bit on the stiffer side. But with this Nike React, I need to admit that this one is not gonna be as heavy as the normal Air Forces 1. And in the same time, it will give a better level of comfort. As in for the actual sizing, guys, for this one, I went with a half size down comparing with my Nike sizing. And that is mainly because I have a skinny feet, and when I'm actually buying Air Force 1, I really feel that here at the front of the shoe, this one is slightly a bit too roomy for me. So that's why I decided to go with that half size down. But in case you have normal feet, I will suggest you to go with your true to size. And depending on how wide your feet will be, I will either suggest you to go with your true to size or even try a half size up. So overall, guys, this new version for the Air Force 1, in my opinion, uses good materials. And I would need to admit that this back part of the shoe, it's gonna be completely changed comparing with the normal Air Forces 1, which I'm not saying that it's a bad thing. But I kind of like these new materials which they brought to this very classic shoe. And I will need to admit that the level of comfort for this one, guys, is gonna be actually quite good. And of course, it's gonna be mainly because of this Nike React foam, which will not be as stiff as the normal rubber midsole which you get in the normal Air Forces 1. So yeah, guys, this was my unboxing and reviewing of this new version for the Nike Air Force 1, which uses this React midsole. I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. You can also give me a follow on Instagram to see exactly what I'm gonna review in the next few days. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching.